Hi guys, welcome back. And I just wanted to do a quick haul video of some of the things that I bought off Amazon. Now these are really inexpensive, cheap brushes and a palette and some sponges that I bought. I just wanted to see how it was. I'll show you the comparison of some of, I wouldn't say higher end, but a little more expensive than these brushes. So this is the first set of brushes that I have, and this is a full set. So you've got some face brushes in here, you've got some eyeshadow brushes. So this is what it looks like. Let's just dump that there. Okay. And I was taking a look at the quality of these brushes, and they're okay. I mean, like, for the price that I paid, I think I paid around 400. I'll leave the prices in the description, but they were less than 500 rupees, I think. Yeah, they were 400 and something for this set of brushes. And I just wanted to try out and see whether, you know, they're worth, you know, because sometimes we buy like the higher end brushes, and brushes are really expensive. Some of them, just one brush sometimes is 1,000 rupees. So I wanted to try like the cheaper end ones. Now the eyeshadow brushes, I want that. I mean, they're a little sparse if you look at them. Like, they're a little sparse. I'll just show you one of the, like, this is, let's see. Okay, so this is like a blending sort of a brush, you know. Yeah, and it seems a little sparse. I'll show you another one that I have from BS Malls, which is, I've just washed all of my brushes, but this is from BS Malls. And it's so much thicker, and it feels so much softer. So I think BS Malls was, again, it's not expensive, but the whole set, it's something similar to this set that I got from BS Malls, and that was around, I think it's around 1,500 rupees for the whole set. But they're really good quality brushes though, so I would recommend you all go for a little more expensive brushes. But if you all are on a budget, you do get similar brushes. Don't expect them to be really thick. I mean, you can work with them, but they're not, you know, as thick as like a good blending brush would be. Like, even if we take this foundation brush that I have from BS Mall, look at the thickness of this. And it is, yeah, here. And look at this. So it's not the best quality, you see, that is a little fatter, and it's thicker, like it's just densely packed. And these are worth it. These BS Mall brushes I really like. But if you're on a budget, so I just wanted to try these out. You can work with these. I mean, they're not terrible. You can work with these if you're on a budget, so try them out. And then I bought some, it says 1200 here, trust me, they were not. I think they were, again, less than 500. I'll leave the prices in the description. But these are just eyeshadow brushes, and this was from Start Makers. And again, I was disappointed in these. I don't know what I expected. I mean, I just wanted to try them out. But they're cheap brushes, obviously, so they're not that densely packed. Let's just put them down over here. And as you can see, they're a little crooked. I think they were just stuffed in the package. This is supposed to be like a blending brush. This brush I liked. This looks like a good brush. But I mean, you get some. This is okay. Yeah. So you get some. You have to always expect some duds in them. But it's okay. For the price, I would say it's okay. This is really sparsely. Yeah. It's okay. And also, I bought the makeup sponges. This was the Amazon sponge. Again, I'll leave it in the description. I think it was really cheap again. I don't remember how much it was, but it was less than 500 again. And this is the sponge without it being dampened. It's got a little dent in there because it was in the package. But this is with us, so it grows quite a bit once you wet it. So this is how much it grows, and it's a little hard on the face. It's a little rubbery and a little hard, not as soft as some of the higher end sponges. Again, I'm not comparing them to like a beauty blender and stuff like that, because obviously the price range is completely different. But you do get better ones, I would say, in this price range, below 500. So, I don't know. I didn't like this so much. So, this was a fail for me. It's a little hard, but I wanted to try it out anyway. I did buy this Wet n Wild eyeshadow primer also. I haven't tried this out, but I think it's a good affordable eyeshadow primer. This was for $4.99. I feel like I paid less though. Maybe I got it on a sale or something, but this is what the eyeshadow primer looks like. And if I remove it from the box, so this is what it is. It's a little small tube. Photo focus. I like Wet n Wild because they're cruelty free. So that's one of the good parts about them. And they're cheap, of course. This little thing I bought again for cleaning my brushes. And I would say if you don't have one of these little things, you should buy them. They're really useful. I just cleaned up most of my brushes. Here are some of my brushes that I just cleaned. These ones. So like I was saying, these are the BS Small brushes. This is like brand new. I haven't even used it. So if you look at it, look at how densely packed that is. I mean, tell me that's not worth it. It's worth the price, even if you're paying a little more. 1,500 also. It's worth it. Those. Never ever buy the color bar brushes. I mean, look at this. This is ridiculous. It's the worst brush I've ever used. It's like so, I don't know what. It's like a broom. It's terrible. Don't ever buy this brush. These are some cheaper brushes that I got from the US. It's just some kids' brushes over there. But anyway, okay. So, moving on to the palette. Now, again, this was a cheap palette. I think it was, again, the Start Makers palette. And this is the packaging. It just tells you the ingredients. And it's just plain in front. Ingredients are not so great, obviously. I mean, the first ingredient is talc. So, I wasn't expecting anything from this. But I just wanted to see where the, you know, these blend and their pigmentation, just to see something that is on the more budget friendly side. And this was really cheap also. I think this was also 500, I want to say 500 rupees. But again, don't quote me on that. I will leave all of the I can't speak. I will leave the prices in the description bar below. And you open it, you've got like this flimsy little whatever plastic bit, and this too, and you remove this, and this is what it looks like. These are the colors. They are quite impressive, I should say, for the amount. I mean, like, if you're comparing it to, I've got to say, Wet n Wild shadows are pretty good, but I have like the Naked palettes, some Sephora palettes and things like that, and they are really creamy shadows. When I buy higher end shadows, I always do my research before I buy them. So I do have a few higher end palettes, but this one was, they look impressive, but let's see how they swatch. Okay, so let's swatch these colors and see how pigmented they are and whether it's just an airbrush. I hope it's these glittery colors that you can see over there. Can you see them? Yeah. So I hope it's not just a top spray like some of the cheaper palettes. Let's just check it out. So let's start from the top. And there are no names or anything on this. They are definitely powdery, as you can see. But I mean, what was I expecting from a cheap palette like this? I'm gonna do some more research on some of the cheaper palettes and see whether there is something that is. No, I'm not impressed at all. Okay, that is really chalky. Can you see that? That just picked up like, if I try to maybe buff it out. I mean, you can work with them, but okay, let's try the others. Let me just quickly grab a makeup wipe and wipe off my fingers. Okay, so let's go in with the others. So that was the first row completely. I think this shade is okay, but the rest of them, not impressing me. Okay, so we'll go in with the next. Wow. Okay, so if you see, this is so powdery, I'm barely going into them. And yeah, that's what happens. Okay, so this one is the first. This is a little, I like this shade. That's not powdery at all. I think the more shimmery shades maybe are not working out as well. This I can't even see. Nope. What's wrong with this one? Oh, that's a pretty one. That's a pretty color. Yeah. That is beautiful. Okay, so the first color I'm absolutely in love with. That one there, that's beautiful. This one. Let's try this. This and this seem very similar. I don't know. Go next to that. No. It is chalky. Chalky central here. Not impressed. Okay, let's try this. Okay, that is not bad. Let's try this shimmer. Oh wow. Okay, so their shimmers are beautiful. So these two colors here and this one are these two. Let's try the others. I'm just gonna go in here. Oh, that's not bad. What's going on? Oh, that's powdery. Wow. Okay. Then we're going into the last two rows. So let's go into this. I'm just gonna put that there. That is a nice color also. So of what I'm seeing, the matte shades aren't that great. That's not so bad. The matte shades aren't that great, but the rest of the shimmers are, some of the shimmers, actually the top few shimmers were not so great. So that is the orange there. A lot of these look like repetitions almost, very little difference between them. Like a lot of coppery brick tones. And then we go in here with another brown matte. Oh, where do I swatch? I don't even have place. Okay, here you go. Yeah. And then the next. That's a nice shade also. Oh, okay. I like that too. And then the last two shades. This is a little chalky. And then we've got the black, which is quite pigmented. So there you go. These are all of the shades swatched. And I would say, if you look at the shimmery ones are the ones that I like. But, I mean, you can't complain for the amount that you're paying. I mean, it is a cheap palette. What do you expect from it? I wonder how these blend, though. So, I'll try them out and I will let you know. But thank you for watching, and I will come back if I find some more affordable palettes that, you know, are good dupes for the higher ends. Thanks, bye.